catch me running. You're moving away that I'm moving. And I breathe your air. Yeah. Oh. Cherish the day.
Alrighty, good morning to all. We're about to get started. At this time, I ask that we will please silence your cell phones. Please silence your cell phones at this time. Thank you so much. And we also ask that you will hold all applause until each name is called. And at the end of the ceremony, you can meet your graduate outside. Again, please, no parents or guests are to be on the floor during the ceremony. And at this time, I would like to introduce Newman University's president, Dr. Chris Domes, for a brief welcome. Let's clap it up.
Good morning. On behalf of all of us here at Newman University, we want to say welcome. It's great to be able to be part of this incredible celebration. We extend our congratulations to all the graduates, but a particular congratulations to the moms and dads, aunts and uncles, guardians, grandparents, brothers and sisters who are here in the audience here today. You have much to celebrate, and Newman University is so proud to be a part of this incredible day. God bless each of you, and have a wonderful celebration.
stripes and bright stars through the perilous light. Oh, the ramparts we watch as the twilight lasts gleaming in the rocket's red glare, the bomb bursting in air gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, who say does that star-spangled banner yet wave? Oh, the land of the free and the home of the
greetings and salutations. Welcome, class of 2023, staff, faculty, and family, to the 2023 commencement ceremony for the Chester Upland School District. I want to thank the families and parents of today's graduates. We are extremely honored to have special people in our audience today. We are excited to introduce our guest speakers who are speaking today, including Michael Robinson, Receiver Nichols, President Neal, and the members of the elected school board, Chester Upland School District Administration, faculty, and staff. I want to personally thank my family, my siblings, my longtime friends, for being by my side when I needed you all the most. Class of 2023, it has been an honor serving as your president, and I cannot wait to see your growth and milestones throughout your journey. Madam President, out. I would like to introduce Briseida Estrada from Chester High, class of 2023.
Bienvenidos a la ceremonia de graduación del 2023 de Chester Upland. Mi nombre es Briseida Estrada y estoy muy orgullosa de mis compañeros y hoy vamos a celebrar nuestro futuro. Quiero decir gracias a los padres y las siguientes personas. El síndico del distrito de Chester Upland, el consejo escolar, la administración de Chester Upland, maestros y todas las personas que trabajan en Chester Upland. Quiero también decir gracias a una de mis maestras favoritas, Miss Bowser. Quiero decirle que la voy a extrañar. A la clase del 2023, mis compañeros, algunos de nosotros vamos a la universidad, otros a trabajar y otros todavía no sabemos. Pero lo que sabemos es que el tiempo en Chester High y STEM Academy fue una memoria que no vamos a olvidar. Felicidades y que todo nos vaya fabuloso. Ahora a celebrar. Con ustedes, el principal, Mr. Brown.
Good morning, Chester High, class of 2023. Good morning. I know y'all get louder than that in the hallway, so let me hear you now. It's your day. Celebrate. There we go. That's what I want to hear. So before I begin my speech, I want to acknowledge the parents, guardians, faculty, and staff of Chester High. Please stand for a round of applause. They work together like a fine oil machine, and the collaboration led us to this day. So make sure you continue to thank them for their support. Good morning to Essential Administration, our school board members, family and friends, and most importantly, the class of Chester High 2023. The class of 2023 from Chester High has weathered a lot of storms, weathered a lot of life challenges, academic challenges, personal challenges, and through your achievement, hard work, and efforts, here we are today. Give yourselves a round of applause. I want to present you with one challenge, class of 2023. I want you to create the life that you want to live, and I want you to love that life. That's a challenge that I have for you. Lastly, I leave you with a positive note. Today marks a milestone in your life. You've overcame obstacles, achieved some great heights, like being a class that had 90% or higher on the senior civics exam. Awesome. Also the class with the highest attendance at Chester High School. Again, awesome challenge. Awesome accomplishment. But lastly, I want you to remember two things. That today, at the end of this ceremony, you have achieved something that no one can take from you. And that something special, my second thing is, you are formally educated. Be proud of that, cherish that. The staff at Chester High School and myself, along with the administration, we love you, we're proud of you, and we congratulate you on this fine day. Congratulations. Next up is my counterpart from STEM Academy High School, Mr. Brendan Bell.
Good morning. Good morning. To the families, the friends, the supporters of graduates, our special and esteemed guests gathered here today, thank you for being here for this celebration. To the teachers, the staff, and all the educators at STEM Academy, at Chester High, and throughout the Chester Upland School District, you have made your mark on these young people, and not one of them would be here today without your guidance and influence. Thank you for your commitment to our students. And to the class of 2023, we are all here together this morning because of you. Life has thrown a lot at you over these past 4 years, but with grit and determination, you made it here. Thank you for your efforts. Please know that in the future, you will need that determination more than anything else you learned here. Your life will be beautiful, but also challenging and unpredictable. So this morning, as we send you off, I'm going to ask you to do 3 more things. First, attack challenges with fierce determination to succeed. You're not always going to win, but be courageous. Don't back down when life gets tough, and never pass up an opportunity because you're afraid to fail. Second, Stay true to yourself and to your values. Know who you are. Life will provide so many chances to abandon your character. Don't allow that to happen. Find the right decision and make it. And third, treat all the people who come into your life with fairness and compassion. In the end, how you treat people is who you are. It's not your house, it's not your job, your position, it's not your car, your money, or your clothes. What you do for others and how you make them feel is who you are. Remember that always. Thank you, class of 2023. It has been a joy to watch you grow, and I cannot wait to see who you become. And now I'd like to introduce receiver of the Chester Upland School District, Mr. Nafis Nichols.
To the administrators, faculty, and staff of the Chester Upland School District, our elected school board members, our municipal elected officials and dignitaries, family and friends, and most importantly to the graduating class of 2023. Good morning. It is a privilege and honor to stand before you and see the sea of orange and black as you are now transitioning into success. This accomplishment that we have here today, that you have here today, you should be very proud of, as I am proud of each and every one of you. I pray and hope and know that you will make a mark in this world. You are the only one that can determine your destination in life and do it with grace. Again, congratulations to each and every one of you, and I welcome you to the illustrious Chester High School Alumni Association. We're here for you. We will never leave you. Reach back and ask for help, and we'll get you through. Congratulations. Congratulations. And now we will have our school board president, Ms. Joan Neal.
Good morning, class of 2023. Good morning to Superintendent Parkinson, Receiver Nichols, administrators, faculty, school board directors, families, and friends. It is a privilege and honor to be here with all of you today and for the opportunity to address the 2023 graduates and your families. Ladies and gentlemen of the class of 2023, you are celebrating both an ending and a beginning. Today is a big deal, not only for you, but for your parents as well. All of you have worked hard to get here, so you are definitely worth celebrating. At some point, you'll look back at what you've accomplished and the good times that you had at Chester High School and STEM Academy. When you look back, think of it as an unforgettable journey that has prepared you for the future and whatever it may hold. I know that these past 4 years have involved some of the most memorable experiences that you will never again, you'll never have again as a high school student. As of today, you will be starting a new chapter in your life, and it's a chapter that you will be writing. Up to this point, you have been ours. Your education was mandatory, but now the choice is yours. You will decide if you will further your education at a 2 or 4 year college or university, or attend a trade school, or seek employment. And if you're still not sure of what interests you, don't worry, give it time. Just go out there with your mind wide open, and you will figure it out. Some of you have chosen to enlist in the military. To you, I say thank you in advance for your service. Jaime Escalante, a Bolivian American educator, once said, "One of the greatest things you have in life is that no one has the authority to tell you what you want to be. You're the one who will decide what you want to be. respect yourself, and respect the integrity of others as well. The greatest thing you have is your self-image, a positive opinion of yourself. You must never let anyone take it from you. In conclusion, in whatever city, state, or country your journey takes you, be confident and take Sea Pride with you. On behalf of myself and the board of directors, congratulations, class of 2023. God bless you and make us proud. Thank you. And now I bring up to the podium Councilman William Morgan from the city of Chester.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Deputy Mayor Will Morgan with the City of Chester, and I want to acknowledge my colleagues as well, Councilwoman Portia West, Councilwoman Elizabeth Williams, and Councilman Stefan Roots, who are present here today. Also, I want to say good morning to the amazing class of 2023. We want to congratulate you for this tremendous milestone. You've pushed through with some early mornings and late nights. You've probably dealt with a tremendous amount of complicated class projects, and you've probably even had a few disagreements with your parents and guardians along the way as well. Nonetheless, that has been a great support system that we all have, and some of those support systems we also consider our friends as well. This is a tremendous milestone and one that you'll forever remember. Just remember that this road of life is a marathon and not a sprint. And this is just one chapter of the book that you are the author in. Now, understand that I said that it's a book. So there's going to be a lot of ups and downs, a lot of disagreements, and a lot of things that you just don't know why the math isn't mathing. But remember that you are Sea Pride. And the grace of God is not going to put you through anything that he knows that you would not be able to prevail and succeed through. So continue to push and continue to have faith. And lastly, I'll end with these quick three things that I say to everyone because I feel like it applies to no matter the age or demographic. But always be a sponge and soak up the knowledge, education, and skill sets that you would need to be successful in this life. All of the greats have done it, and you can too. ABP, always be prepared, because you never know where you are or who you'll be in the room with. So the next time you're in that room, you can be able to present that project or the business plan that you're the entrepreneur of in front of the Googles and the Amazons of the world. And lastly, take care of your health. Take care of your bodies. It's important. You only get one. Take care of your bodies. Secondly, I pray that you all create wealth. And I'm just not just talking about wealth. I'm talking about generational wealth. Because it's nothing like when you can be able to bear the fruits of your labor and enjoy the beautiful things in life with your friends and your family. And lastly, I just pray that you all be successful in the things that you want to do in life as long as they are the positive things. So I and we thank you, we love you, and we congratulate you, the class of 2023. Thank you.
Good morning, staff, faculty, administrators, and let's not forget the class of 2023. I am Jayla Pratt, Chester High School Senior President. I am so excited to gather here to celebrate our high school journey and embark on a new chapter of our lives. Let's cherish the memories we have made, the friendships we have formed, and the lessons we have learned. As we move forward on our individual journeys, I would like to say congratulations, class of 2023. Let me introduce Reverend Michael Robinson, M.S., serves as the senior pastor for Greater Enoch Missionary Baptist Church in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, and as the director of community outreach and hiring for the Temple University Linfest North Philadelphia Workforce Initiative. Reverend Robinson has also served as an appointed member to the Governor's Commission on African American Affairs, as an appointed member to the Community Advisory Committee for the Southeastern Pennsylvania Transportation Authority for Delaware County. As a columnist for Scoop USA newspaper and as a member of the Pennsylvania News Media, the Association and the Society of Human Resources and Management. Reverend Robertson holds a Master of Science degree in Christian Counseling from Karen University and a Bachelor of Science degree in Communications from Clarion University of Pennsylvania. Reverend Robertson has received many awards for his expositional services, including the Citizens Award from Philadelphia Department of Prisons and the Industry Icon Award from Philadelphia Inquirer Newspapers. Please welcome our esteemed guest speaker, Reverend Michael Robertson.
Class of 2023. Let's give it up for the class of 2023. Oh, y'all can do better than that. Y'all been through a pandemic. You've been through some fire. You've been through some grief. We came up from the bottom, now we're here. Come on, let's give it up for the class of 2023. Congratulations to all of the officers of this class, to all of the administration, to all of the parents. To all of the family, friends, and loved ones that are assembled to honor the class of 2023, we welcome you all. I am happy to be here. I count this a great honor. I am a native son of Chester, Pennsylvania. I grew up in the Bennett Home Project graveyard. Any Bennett Home folk up in the house? Got a few of y'all up in here. So it's good coming back to my esteemed high school. And I just want to be very brief in my encouragement to this great class. Theodore Roosevelt once said, in any moment of decision, the best thing you can do is the right thing. The next thing is the wrong thing. And the third thing is to do nothing at all. My encouragement to you is to be activated, to be good decision makers. You and I are the consequence of good and bad choices, the manifestation of thought. Our thoughts dictate our choices. Our choices dictate good or bad consequences. Our consequences dictate the measure of success or failure that you will reap. If you want to be successful in life, be intentional about making good decisions. According to a CNN report, they say that your brain makes upwards of about 35,000 decisions each day. That's a lot of decision making on a daily basis. Minor and major decisions that will shape whether you are a success or whether you are a failure. Every day we are faced with choices, both big and small, that can have a significant impact on our lives and the lives of those around us. So if you are going to be a good decision maker, number one, be well informed. Become a lifelong learner. Gather as much information and wisdom as you can. Wisdom is the principal thing. Therefore, get it. And in all thy getting, get understanding. Read often. Read the newspaper. Read books. Read magazines. Read online news sources. But read. Reading helps expand your content knowledge. The more you know, the more you know. Secondly, weigh the pros and cons of your choices. Every decision has its advantages and disadvantages. One decision can change your life for the better or for the worse. Every decision has consequences. Some consequences aren't easy to rebound from. Some consequences you don't rebound from. Consider your short-term and long-term consequences with each choice and decision you make. Thirdly, trust your instincts. God gave us all a moral GPS system to determine whether we're moving in a right or wrong direction. Your intuition is powerful. It's a powerful tool that will let you know whether or not you're doing the right thing or the wrong thing. When I was growing up, when I was your age back in 1953, when I was your age, I used to love this cartoon called Spider-Man. And Spider-Man had this superpower called spider sense. His spidey sense was tingling anytime there was danger afoot. You have that moral compass in you to determine if the crowd you're around is good or the crowd you're around are bad. Everybody hold up the OK sign. Everybody hold up the OK sign. Wave it like you just OK. No, I'm just kidding. Hold up the OK sign. Now do me a favor. Put it on your chin. How many people put it on their cheek? I said your chin. I gave you a simple direction, but based on what you thought was right, you did the wrong thing. My point being, the type of crowd you surround yourself with will influence you the greatest. I want to give you several things that you can hold on to practically to move forward in a positive direction, making good choices in your life. Number one, determine what type of person you want to be. Do you want to be a visionary, somebody who's creative, innovative? We need creative, innovative, visionary people who can come up with the big ideas, the new thing that can radically change things for the better. Start small and think big. Secondly, be a guardian. What type of person do you want to be? A visionary or a guardian? A guardian is a protective individual, one who looks out for the community, one who looks out for their family, their friends. This individual is concerned about others. They highly esteem others, and they don't mind serving. What kind of person do you want to be? A visionary, guardian, or a motivator? A motivator is inspiring. They're the cheerleaders of the world. They're the ones that when you're down, when you're depressed, when you've been beat down by life, these are the individuals that say you can get up, dust yourself off, and keep it moving. These are the individuals that you need to surround yourself with when you have nothing left in the tank. Do you want to be a visionary, a guardian, a motivator, or are you going to be that flexible individual, the one who is willing to pivot when disaster happens? One of the things I got to give y'all big ups on as a class of 2023, y'all been through some hell. Y'all been through a pandemic. Look, and you're still standing. Amen, somebody. You're here. Some of y'all survived some death situations. Some of y'all survived some sicknesses. But you're still here. And as long as you're standing, make something meaningful out of your life. Learn how to pivot. If one thing the pandemic taught us, it taught us how to be flexible and pivot. And then finally, be a catalyst. Be a change agent. Be someone that sees a problem and doesn't run away from it, but sees a problem and deals with it head on. Don't be a punk. Don't be shy. You are from Chester. What Chester makes, makes Chester. Theodore Roosevelt, I opened up with him and I'm going to close with him. He wrote, in 1914, one of the greatest speeches ever recorded. And an excerpt, a small excerpt of that speech, he encourages us to get in the arena, to get into the arena of life, not to sit in the stands as a spectator, but to get into the arena, to be that gladiator, to put forth a fighting effort, to make sure that you're all about action and not inaction. And the speech that ranks among the top 100, that little excerpt I want to leave with you today. It's not the critic who counts, not the man who points out how the strong man stumbles, or where the doer of deeds could have done them better. The credit belongs to the man who is actually in the arena, whose face is marred by dust and sweat and blood, who strives valiantly, who errs, who comes up short again and again. And because there's no effort without error and shortcoming, but who does actually strive to do the deeds, who knows the great enthusiasms, the great devotions, who spends himself or herself in a worthy cause, who at best knows in the end the triumph of high achievement, and who at worst, if he or she fails, at least fails while daring greatly, so that his or her place shall never be with those cold and timid souls who knew neither victory nor defeat. God bless you, class of 2023. I am proud of you. I wish you the best, and may you have an extremely abundant, joy-filled life. God bless you.
Good morning, respected faculty members, parents, fellow graduates, and distinguished guests. My name is Poi Pailin Sapatmisai from the graduating class of 2023. Before I can begin, I want to take a moment to commend all of my fellow graduates in this room today. I'm sure your friends and family are proud of you, as am I. 4 years of your cumulative efforts have led you to this point, and it has earned you this moment of recognition and celebration. As I stand here as salutatorian, it is an honor to have the opportunity to speak before you on behalf of my fellow graduates. I want to take these last moments we have together to encourage each of you to take whatever opportunity comes your way and make your own success. Even when you find yourself feeling hopeless and you find that there are no opportunities to pursue, remember that you are the only one in charge of your own future. If you find that there are no opportunities available, then create your own. I want each of you here to realize your potential is limitless, and it is not defined by your circumstances. Even if you come from a disadvantaged background or an unfavorable situation, that does not mean you cannot achieve great things. If anything, that is all the more reason to make sure you succeed. I have also thought that my circumstances would hold me back, but I quickly realized that the only thing stopping me was myself. I took a chance to shape my own future, and I encourage all of you to do the same. No matter what it is you decide to do, when you find yourself feeling unconfident or that you aren't good enough, please remember that the only person truly stopping you from achieving what you want is yourself. You have come a long way to get where you are today. Use what you've learned as a foundation for your future success. I congratulate all of you, class of 2023, and I wish for the best on whatever task you choose to take.
Good morning, graduating class, families, faculty, district administration, and city officials, and welcome to the graduation of Chester High School and STEM Academy, class of 2023. Every one of you has made an impact on the graduates who sit here today, and it is my honor to deliver a commencement address on behalf of this astounding student body. Today we gather to celebrate the incredible journey we have undertaken as a graduating class. Our years in high school have been filled with joy, challenges, laughter, and tears. And despite numerous setbacks, we have continuously shown our ability to remain tenacious even when obstacles were thrown at us. Hence why we are here today. Today marks a significant milestone in our young lives worth celebrating. We first entered high school with hopes of experiencing the traditional path, filled with football games, proms, and other memorable moments with friends. Unfortunately, our hopes were shattered as news of a virus came out, spreading fear and uncertainty throughout the world. Our lives were suddenly disrupted, and the world as we knew transformed before our eyes. Schools closed, and classrooms were replaced with online platforms and video conferences. The hallways that were once filled with laughter were silent. The extracurricular activities we eagerly wanted to join were put on hold. Our cherished milestones like prom and graduation were suddenly uncertain. We were forced to adapt to a new reality, one that demanded resilience and perseverance. We had to learn to navigate a virtual landscape while maintaining our focus and motivation. Fortunately, we were able to return to school for our 11th grade year, which I'm sure for most of us was good news. Regaining the ability to connect and socialize physically was a joy we all hoped to experience again. As a result, we learned to appreciate the little things we once took for granted. The warmth of a hug, the sound of laughter in the hallways, and even the simple joy of getting together. The impact of the pandemic has tested our resilience and challenged our adaptability. But through it all, we have shown remarkable strength. In the face of hardship, we supported each other, offering words of encouragement, lending a helping hand, and embracing the power of unity. Our teachers and school staff worked tirelessly to ensure we continued our education, guiding us through virtual classrooms and online assignments. They became the hope, reminding us learning has no boundaries. Once again, congratulations to my fellow graduates. Not only is this the end, but it is also the beginning of a new chapter of our lives. I hope that you embrace the memories and valuable lessons learned throughout our years together and inspire those around you to dream and aspire. And now the valedictorian of STEM Academy, Elizabeth Lassende.
Good morning, school administration, faculty members, families, friends, and most importantly, the graduating class of 2023. My name is Elizabeth Lassende, and I stand before you today as the valedictorian of STEM Academy. I want to take this opportunity to congratulate every single one of the graduating seniors for making it to this momentous milestone in their lives. As I reflect on my time here at STEM Academy, there has been a quote that has guided my journey to where I am today. She believed she could, so she did. I discovered this quote before entering high school, and it has stuck with me for the past 4 years. We have all faced many different obstacles and struggles through our time as high school students, but the most impactful was the pandemic. Most of the time, the pandemic is associated with negative thoughts or negative outcomes, but I use the pandemic as a period of growth. Although we were isolated at times, I was hopeful that we'll be physically back together because we should never let what we cannot do guide what we are supposed to do. I didn't allow challenges such as the pandemic to influence how my time in high school went, as well as affect the academic goals that I set for myself when I started my high school journey. But I didn't get to where I am today alone, as I'm sure you didn't either. I got here with the love and support of my parents and teachers. I want to personally take this time to first thank my parents for all that they have done, as well as the words of encouragement whenever I felt I couldn't move forward in certain aspects of my life, as well as a special thank you to the teachers for taking time to understand and support me as a student. I want to remind everyone that in the coming future, there will be obstacles and struggles that may hinder your journey to success. However, by having a helpful tactic such as reflection in your arsenal, you can overcome these hurdles more easily. Take some time to reflect on all your accomplishments. what you have achieved so far, and even to reflect on the things that didn't go so well. Think about all those who have supported or inspired you along the way, whether it's through their guidance or actions. In the words of Michael Jordan, obstacles do not have to stop you. If you run into a wall, don't turn around and give up. Figure out how to climb it, go through it, or work around it. Congratulations to the class of 2023. I would now like to introduce Mr. Craig Parkinson, the superintendent of Chester Upland School District.
All right. Good morning, Chester Upland School District, class of 23. Listen, I'm going to go off script just for a brief moment, and then I'll get into my words. This is Chester Upland School District. Last year, the energy was so high. I'm looking at my graduates in the audience right now. I want to see that energy. This is a special, special day for each and every one of you. Let's be proud, all right? Give me a little energy, graduates. A little energy. That's what I'm looking for, a little energy. All right, all right. Good morning, Chester Upland School District, class of 23, and congratulations on this amazing accomplishment. I want you to know that you have accomplished something extremely significant today. You're receiving your high school diploma. This document that you will receive will open up many doors for you and will help you to place yourself on a pathway of continued success. Our world and community are in need of change agents, and we heard that this morning from Mr. Robinson. Individuals who can go out and make a positive difference in a world that is facing so many challenges. I ask that each of you take what you have earned, and you've earned this diploma, and use it in a way to make a difference in this world. There is no better group of students equipped to do what is needed to move things forward. You have persevered and demonstrated unmatched resiliency. You have overcome challenges of once in a century, a pandemic. You have overcome that. We live in a world where information flows in real time. Social media, and we know at times can be extremely helpful, but we also know that it can be harmful. However, you have been able to surpass these challenges, and today we celebrate you and honor your achievements, the class of 2023. Class of 2023, I challenge you this morning to go out and do your part to make this world a better place for those who will be coming behind you. Congratulations on all of your recent accomplishments, and I'm truly looking forward to see what is next. Congratulations, class of 2023. This is by far the most enjoyable part for me this morning. With the class of 2023, please rise. Class of 2023, it is my honor to certify the class of 2023 for graduation. Receiver Nichols, who had to go and be with his daughter for her graduation. Members of the school board of directors, it is my pleasure to present to you the class of 2023. As a commissioned officer of the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, I hereby attest that each class member standing before you has completed all of the academic requirements of the Pennsylvania Department of Education, as well as the requirements of the Chester Upland Board of Directors. By the authority vested in me, I recommend that the students before you be approved as graduates of the Chester Upland School District, entitled to all rights and privileges and responsibilities that accompany them. Ladies and gentlemen, I proudly present to you the class of 2023 for the awarding of their individual diplomas.
Thank you. So at this time, all students will be reseated until your row is called. All students are reseated.
Yolanda Baker. Yolanda Baker.
Elizabeth Lasende. Poipilin Sopapmisai.
Jayla Pratt.
Mariama Diallo.
Priscilla Estrella.
Malachi Jackson.
Sanaya J. Best.
Cameron Mills.
Tamia James. Kalima Donaldson.
Zion Spotwood.
Leandro Spatulet.
Dakota Richards. Devon Beaver. Terrence Cobb.
Cameron Walker.
Charles Thompson. Benjamin Bell. Colin Farrell.
Mykara Edwards. Sada Floyd Bay. Darren Alavez. Maria Aurelia. Ramaja Dale.
Antonasia Henson. Brianna Walker. Hold on. Nashe Madison. Dayan Jackson. Hold on. Aramis Hernandez. Justin Arroyo Begon.
Hold on.
Ali Goodman. Noble Thompson.
Hold on.
Ashad Brown. Desmond Williams. Akai Sanders. Christopher LaRoche.
Hold on.
Samad Watson.
Hold on.
Imani Satchel. Adriana Ortiz Garcia. Laraya Floyd.
Ayana Alexander. Jayana Peterson.
Zanae Holland Barksdale. Kashmala. Angelina Figueroa. Jacqueline Lee. Angelina Casimir. Terrence Bright.
Leandrin Maladano. Guillermo Perez Tima. Demison Cavarado. Eric Felix. Jonathan Gonzalez. Salvin Lopez. Nelson Saul Pop. Brent Harding. Naima Muhammad.
Nayana Muhammad.
Monica Powell.
Kwamira Yates. Arnay Burton. Keviana Frazier. Hamima Martin.
Ready? Ashley Womack.
Jayani Barber.
Damir Freeman. Kassir Ballard. Samaj Glover. Hayu Mathis.
Eliel Padilla.
Elijah York.
Isaiah Shaughnessy.
Jamil Majid. Zamir Chapman. Zamir Chapman. Brianna Save Coleman Sierra. Siani Williams. Anasia Foster. Jada Chandler. Janai Thomas. Jashay Freeman. Kahira Anissa Jefferson. Glendy Suarez Salvador. Sanaya Taff. Micaiah Smith. Colleen Stevens.
Andrew Fisher.
Kareem Johnson. What's your last name? Iman Bay. Iman Bay. Isaac Singleton. Joel Morello. Jeremiah Gates.
Jabri Davis.
Akil Austin.
Shaquille Austin. Taquan DeShields. Rhea Holm-Bernard. Ronisha Watley. Anaya Brown. Tyasia Grasty.
Ready.
Zakiya Brown. Janai Mills. Janasia Nicholson. Janai Holliger. Amaya Triggs Cooper. Tony Campbell. Samir Brown. Travis Newsom. Jermaine Lane. Kamir Jernigan. Laquan Johnson.
Ready?
Keon Robinson. Paul Stansberry. Brandon L. Anderson. Kashmir Bradley.
Dayani Sadler. Renaya Norell. Janaya Hampton.
Tayshana Green. Michaela Barrett. Anijah Muhammad. Rakaya Sabri. Juliani Moran.
What's your last name? Salah.
Nuran Salah. Tanaya Northern.
Rodney Wadley.
Melvin Pulliam.
Gene Bradley.
Wait, hold on.
Damir Davis. Brian Jimenez.
Jabril Bay. Angelus Williams.
Jonathan Massa.
Amari Brown. Shayana Glover.
Tanaya Davis. Samira Ingram.
Maya Wesley. Susie Elizabeth Cholo Pop. Nikita Saunders. Tayana McCray. Armani Freisen.
Keijon Mathis. Jose Colon Felix.
Jones.
Jaden.
Mm-hmm. Jaden Mills.
David Williams.
Dante Powell. James Carr Jr. Deshaun Lawrence. Tamir Pender.
Wait.
Keyshawn Harris Payne. Shayana Ware. Faith Goldsboro. Amira Smith. Nyasia Bacon. Jemiah Frisbee. Amaya Costin. Cachet Staples. Nyasia Dale. Anya Marie Bush. Jakiah Neal.
Zakeem Harris.
Ready.
Ivan LeBron.
Janiel Santiago Delgado. Tavon Granberry.
Antonio Stevenson.
Karan Wilson.
Andre West. Taquan Seals. Amaria Grittens. Tanaje Henry.
Mahaya
Pierce. Kalia Black. Angel Harris. Maria Rivera.
Jacqueline Hernandez Garcia. Davina Dennis. Armani Mitchell.
Tanaya Ware.
Shakir Willis.
Rafael Nuevez.
Ready?
Zanir Cameron.
You ready?
Jaden Bantam.
Malachi Pettiford.
Steven Turner. Bahir Green. Josiah Cruz.
Kabir.
Kabir Bennett.
Jalen Hutterson.
Sarah Payne.
Hannah Jones. Kanea York.
Okay.
house.
Josiah Muhammad.
Hold on.
Ajanae Watkins Childs. Amaya Horsey.
Ready?
Omariana Taylor. Manaja Johnson. Michaela Ramsey.
Wilfredo Carabello. Gabriel Echevarria.
Kymene Bennett.
Shane Garnett. Walton Garnett.
Ryan Randall.
Ryan Randall?
Yeah. My first name is Ryan and my last name is Randall.
Okay. Ryan Randall.
Brina White. Stop.
Ready?
Braylon White.
Damir Ellis.
Damir Ellis. Melody Brown. Serenity Thomas.
Jamara Gibbs, yeah.
Jamara Gibbs.
Shania Sattler.
Shania.
Shania Sattler.
Javiah Mathis.
Tyra Thompson.
Yeah. Tyra Thomas. Candace Cates. Talia Smith. Shamai Johnson. Nasir Madison Middleton. Deshaun Davis. Jamar Carey.
Yeah, DZ.
Wally Simpson.
Yeah, wow, Jolly.
Corey Sharp. Joseph Nickens. Michael Albertson. Jaheim Johnson. Jefferson King. Jasir Guy.
How you say it?
Reina Nakira. Miriam Mattis. Cindy Jaquan.
First name, Anasia.
Anasia Bird.
Jadira Hassam. Nancy Howard.
Evasia Word.
Janaya
McCullen.
Zaima Sabri.
Lynette Robles. Ramir McBride. LaFennis Mays Jr. Ibrahim Torre. Nazir Berry. Samaj McGraw. Jabril Carter. Marquise Bird. Ricardo Colon Fernandez. Ahmad Morris. Asia Ashley Anderson. Brianna Washington.
Oh my God. Azalea Berry.
Azalea Berry.
Anise Handy. You don't even need this. No.
Alicia Harding. Alina Williams. Bahira Green.
Anaya Mallory.
Anaya Mallory. Shamaya Page. Jawan Scott. Elijah Knox. Jasir Berry. Trey Jones. Tavon Lucas. Lazeal Carter. Jared Watson. Zamir Frisbee. Jaleel Woodward.
Nakeem Cromartie.
Anijah Greer. Denise Walker.
Ready? Scarborough.
Sierra Scarborough.
Kijana
Brown.
Diana Ricketts. Najee Todd.
Tajay Scott. Kiara Scott. Jahira Bagley. Melissa Rice. Sinai Ibrahim. Takaira Irving Sattler. Carrie Ann Gonzalez Colon.
Nineshka Nieves.
Nineshka Nieves. Figueroa. Mercedes Arroyo. Tiana Camacho. Danielle Moore. Kyla Womack.
Najee Middleton. Naeja Pierce.
Elwina Tedla. Kanaya Dallum. Tanaya Jones. Suleska Nieves. Jasmine Rodriguez. Emily Rivas. Ciesha Holmes.
Daykara Walker. Kayana Pressberry. Jasmine Rashid Bacon.
Ready?
Zakiya Drayton. Araya Crosby. Asia Ramsey.
Noelina Clement.
Okay. Noelina Clement.
Shania Council.
Are you the last one, Nicole?
Desire Dupree. And Nicole Scott.
We will now turn your tassels from right to left. You are graduated. Congratulations.